Bless him, God.
Hey, man, it's good to be here tonight. Thank the Lord again for the opportunity and privilege that we have.
Amen.
I thought we've blessed today, amen, to be able to come back tonight. I thank the Lord for this morning. Praise the Lord for what he's done and services all around. I thank God tonight that he's still God. Thank you.
Amen.
I'm glad tonight he's still in control. I'm glad, praise the Lord, that he'll protect us.
Amen.
Help us. Keep us.
Amen.
Amen. I'm glad tonight that he'll guide our footsteps. I thought about it. He said this right here was a lamp unto my feet, didn't he, and a light unto my path.
Yes.
And I'm glad I can stand on that today.
Amen.
I've got the word. I thought about, was thinking there this past week about the word. I thought, I'm glad regardless if they take this book, they can't take it.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. That's why it's important tonight to stay in the book.
Amen.
Stay in the word. And I praise God for that. I thought about too, if you really think about it, I was thinking there about this precious book here. Jesus Christ, the scripture tells us in there that Jesus in the volume of a book.
Amen.
And I thought about when you look at your Bible, that's Jesus.
Yeah,
man. That's right.
That's it.
And I thought we're living in a time today to where probably, no doubt, maybe the less read book they are.
Oh, yes. Right.
And we're blessed today with more of them than we've ever had.
Amen. Amen.
So I praise the Lord tonight for my Bible. I thank the Lord for their guidance and help tonight. Amen.
Yeah.
Pray much for the service tonight. Pray that God just move in, take over. I thought, just looking for a good time tonight in the Lord. Amen. Got much to pray about. Remember the lost. Pray much for them. Remember the sick tonight, afflicted throughout our land.
Amen.
I thought about, I like to just remember the Miller family. That's right, sis. Praise the Lord. I thought about the Miller family. Really pray for those, James and Rick, different ones. Remember that family tonight.
Yes.
I told the church this morning, I said that family's been devastated.
Yeah.
There was Charlie. You see, there was Charlie and James and Rick and Johnny and Donna. Charlie died with cancer. Johnny died with cancer. They had a sister that got cancer. Lester, didn't he have cancer? The dad. And now they diagnosed the other two brothers, right?
Yeah.
Rick and James.
Mm-hmm. Rick, I know. I hadn't heard about James.
Rick. Somebody's mentioned James, and I thought about cancer has hit that family. So really pray for them folks tonight, amen. God give them courage and strength and help them tonight.
Amen.
Any unspoken objects tonight?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Any special spoken ones?
I want to remember me this week. I have a decision I have to make, and I want God
Amen.
I just
want
to remember that.
Amen.
And I know.
Yes.
Amen.
Remember our school teachers? Pray for our schools.
Amen.
Let's come pray.
Amen.
Precious Lord, we come to you tonight and shout to you, God, I thank you, Lord, today.
God, bless us, 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 God, bless us,
Honestly, what we ask God to glorify your name, God, to give you the praise, God. Let every word be spoken that should and nothing that should, God, to give you the glory and the praise. God, for all that you do, Lord, happy tonight, I thank you for all you've done. God, this week, thank you for the hardships, God, help, God, thank you for those that, Lord, move to the truth. God, ask what you'd help us, Lord, to take the words that we've heard this week, God, live by them. Lord, we give you the praise, Lord, for all that you do in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Come on, young people.
Old people. Praise the Lord.
I got up this morning and started my day. God's mercy was with me all of the way. His goodness stays close by to meet all my needs. My Lord is taking good care of me. I'm never forsaken. I'm
thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. the same.
Thank you, Lord God.
Good job.
Good job. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Didn't go for my least thing, only. Amen. Praise the Lord.
That's a mark.
Praise his holy name.
Thank you, Lord. Yeah.
Obey the Lord.
Yes.
Bless you, Lord.
Touch him, God.
Bless him.
Touch him, Lord.
Bless him, Lord. Touch him.
With your spirit, and I praise your holy name.
Amen.
But oh precious Lord,
yeah.
That others see,
yes.
Your holy spirit,
yes, Lord, that is God.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Yes.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
That would hinder my sweet walk.
Amen.
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 There's no hiding, it's wonderful.
Yeah.
My family and children,
yes.
My neighbors,
yes.
And all my friends, when I'm in Jesus,
yes.
All others will know.
Amen. Oh, yeah. Tonight for that. Come on, son. Pray for them as they come. Amen.
Touch him, Lord.
Bless him, Lord. Lord, have your way.
Touch him, God.
Come on, buddy.
Help him, Lord, today. Touch him, God.
Really listen to the words of this song.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, God, touch
him,
Lord.
Touch him, Lord.
Help him, God.
I was on my way home, I was walking alone, on a park bench I passed this old man.
That's a wrong.
Said, sir, could you lend me some spare change? I haven't eaten since I don't know.
Amen. When. Bless him, Lord.
I thought in my mind, well, he wants to get high, so I spoke up and said, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Oh, look where he's on us.
Yeah.
And where
he's on us.
Praise the Lord.
If not for the blood
yeah.
He shed, on all of you.
Praise the Lord. Bless him, Lord.
Touch him, Lord.
Lord, touch him.
Help him, Jesus.
Bless him, Lord.
Touch him, Lord. Lord, help him.
As I turned back around, I could see the man frown as I slowly approached him again. I said, sir, could I tell you a story of how you'll never go hungry again. Well, he looked up and smiled as we spoke for a while, as I told him all Jesus had done.
Oh, yeah.
And right there in that place, through mercy and grace, God's sake, another sinner was born.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Touch them, God.
Thank
you, Jesus. Help them, Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Don't get, you can't give up, can we?
Amen.
Right.
Amen.
Keep trying to get it. Thank God.
Amen.
Touch them, Lord.
Bless them, Lord.
Lord.
Touch
him, God.
If you have friends in glory,
thank you, Lord.
Who left because of pain?
Oh, yeah.
There'll be no pain.
Praise the Lord.
Where there'll be no weeping no more.
Yeah.
There'll be no death no more. There'll
Help
be no
Lord.
Sadness no more. There'll be no pain, no anguish. There'll
yes,
be no
amen,
death
brother.
No more. There'll not be no lame no more.
No.
There'll be none of that. Amen.
No.
When we get the Lord of land.
Thank you,
amen.
Lord.
It's Let's all going to be better. Amen. So you pray for me tonight. Amen, that this cord don't get my way. But I thought about the song and what it really said and got to thinking really of what Glory Land's going to be like.
Yeah,
and
yes.
Every one of us is sitting under the tent tonight. We've got a past of where we come from.
Amen.
Amen. Every one of us know the anguish and the pain that we're in. And now we're all in a glory land in our own natural life. We're in a glory land.
being saved. We rejoice. There's no other feeling, Brother Paul, like being saved. It's a happiness that we're living here, but we're coming to a glad tomorrow. Amen. For all the children of God. Amen. It's been born again. And that was the glory land that we sung about. There's coming a place that there'll be no need for all the lights. And I thought, I looked around at these lights in the tent. There'll be no need for them. For Christ himself, Brother Trent's going to be a light. Amen. So I'm thankful tonight. Amen. For a place. Amen. That we're going to get to go to be with the Lord. Amen. All the things that we go through, death is a sorrowful thing. Amen. But there'll be no death over there. Amen. There'll be none of that. Amen. So I'm thankful and grateful tonight. Amen. That I've got a better place to go. Amen. I don't have to worry. I thought lost people in the day's time, they ain't got nothing to look forward to. Amen. The only thing the lost man's got to look forward to is the next high or the next drunk. Amen. Yeah. But me and a fella was talking the other day. Amen. The world, they try to say, well, you've never had a high. Uh-huh. Amen. Like drugs. Amen. Yeah, I have. There's nothing that can replace the Holy Ghost. Amen. Getting a high in the Holy Ghost. Amen. They'll say, well, there ain't nothing like getting drunk. Amen. And losing your mind. There ain't nothing that can take the water. Yeah. Amen. That the Lord has put the well of water. He said, that I give you. There ain't nothing that can replace that. Amen. So I mean, I'm getting all the things that they're getting, but in a whole different, better form. Amen. So I'm glad to be saved tonight. Amen. I'm glad to see you here tonight. So you pray for us that the Lord would anoint us tonight. I didn't know that I would come back last night. Amen. But coming to get the van to church yesterday evening, the Lord gave me a message. And I feel like that I have to preach it. So you pray really hard for it tonight. Amen. Matthew chapter number 24. Very familiar scripture, but an awful strange thought. So you just have to bear with me tonight. Then the Lord will help me. Amen. Amen. Matthew chapter 24. Very familiar scripture. Talking about the coming and the day of the Lord. And I do believe that it's a coming.
Amen.
Amen. Many have tried to predict, Brother Trent, the day of the Lord, but nobody knows the day or the hour that the Son of Man's coming. So you pray for me. Verse number 36, Matthew 24 says, but of the day and hour knoweth no man, no, not the angels of heaven, but my Father only. But as the days of Noah were, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. For as in the days that were before the flood, they were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage, unto the day that Noah entered into the ark, and knew not until the flood came and took them all away. So shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. That's all I feel like reading. A strange thought that the Lord gave me, and I'm going to have to use some natural tonight to try to get to where the Lord would have me to go. I think it was when we put up the tent, whenever we come up here and then we left and all went our separate ways. And I got down there and later on in that evening, I believe it was, and Saturday evening, and I was leaving, going back to the house. I'd pulled out a fast stop. Y'all from Burnsville know where I'm talking about. But I'd pulled out a fast stop, amen, and didn't put my seatbelt on. And my truck has an alarm on the seatbelt, and it'll ding. It'll ding, 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 ding until you put your seatbelt on.
Yeah.
But as the days and the months that I've had that truck has went by, Brother Aaron, I just got to where I didn't pay that alarm no attention.
Come on, bro.
And then when I remembered that alarm, Brother Mark, was when the blue lights come on behind me. Yeah. I remembered that alarm would have saved me that cop pulling me over. Uh-huh. And then got on up there and he gave me a ticket, amen, that I had to go to the courthouse and take care of. Because you pray I'm going somewhere. Because of my getting used, amen, to the Lord. Amen. And I want to preach a thought tonight. We've got a used to the Lord. Amen. We've got used to the Lord.
Yeah.
But I thought when the Lord brought it to my mind, I got down to the end of the school road yesterday, and that alarm, it started dinging again. Amen. Dinging again. Well, at that time, I didn't ignore it because I know what it cost me the last time. Amen. So I reached and got the seatbelt and I put it on. But here's where the Lord has took me to this scripture. I'm seeing a church world and a people that's in the church. Amen. That's got used to the alarm. Amen. When we hear the preacher preach, amen, service after service, and we hear him sound out the alarm, and we hear him sound out the warning, amen, to the people of God, that we must do right, and we must straighten our ways up, and that we must get rid of wickedness, and we must quit living an iniquity life. But we've got used to hearing that so long now that we've just got used to the alarm. And here's the way that I thought before I got pulled over, amen. I got to a place in my natural life, Brother Paul, that I'd say, well, if I can bear the alarm, amen, for just about 15 to 20 minutes, amen, it'll be over and it'll quit. Amen. But that's where we got at in the church. Amen. We've got to a place, amen, up to where we know if we can just bear with the preacher up for 35, 45 minutes, we know the alarm will be over. And we'll do the same thing that we've always done. And we'll do the same thing. We'll live the same life that we've always lived. Amen. But my mind today is the Holy Ghost. Me and the Holy Ghost was talking, amen, about tonight. He took me to Noah. And the Bible, amen, sent a warning, amen, to the people. Amen. He told Noah, he said, I saw the wickedness of men come before mine eyes. And he said, I'm going to destroy, amen, the men and women off the face of the earth. Amen. So Noah got to a place. And God told him, but the Bible said that Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. Now I want you to really think about that tonight. That Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. Amen. But then he thought Noah would begin to build the ark. God commanded him to build an ark. And the Bible tells Noah, amen, when God spake to him, Brother Todd, he told him exactly how to build it. He told him what to build it out of. He told him every step to take. What was Noah doing when God commanded him to build the ark? God was sending a warning. Now it had rained in a long time. Amen. In the earth. But now the people, they come by and they see Noah out there building an ark. And no doubt the thought that entered their mind, like some of our people in the churches, they wonder, why did the man of God preach on that? Why does he do that? Why do they think that it takes that to live right? They don't take that to live right. You can do what you want to and still go to heaven as long as you've been saved. Friend, I'll tell you what you've done. You've got used to the alarm. You've got used to the alarm. You know that if you can bear it just for a little while, until you find another church, or till you find another preacher, that the alarm will be over and you go on again. But knowing no doubt, they come by, Brother Paul, and they made fun of Noah, and they made light of him, and said, what a foolish man you are, out here in the middle of the desert, building an ark, seeing it ain't rain, and there's no water upon the earth. But Noah still done what God wanted him to do. Amen. Oh, my, tonight, if I can get you to understand that the people God used to the alarm, they wanted their wickedness more than they wanted the righteousness of God. Amen. And they wanted to do what they wanted to do. Yeah. And they didn't want to change their way. Amen. Oh, my, but Noah, he kept on building the ark. Oh, yeah. He kept on driving the nails. Yeah. Every nail that I believe that Noah hid, it was a reminder of the alarm that was sounding. Yeah. Amen. When they walked by, I believe Noah just hung his head in shame and looked at them. My Bible said that Noah, Brother Trent, was a preacher of righteousness. Yeah. And I believe that Noah, every time that they walked by, and they might have made light of him, Brother Curtis, I believe that Noah said, you better consider your ways. Yeah. God's surely going to come. Yeah. And God's going to float the moon. And God sounded the warning. And when the warning goes on, the blue light is on, and it's behind you. and it's too late.
Amen.
We've got used to preachers preaching on holiness so much anymore it don't stir us.
That's right.
We've got used to people preaching anymore it don't move us.
Yeah. Right.
Amen. Y'all bear with me. There's not a doubt in my mind God laid this on my heart.
Yeah,
amen. But Noah began to drive the nails. Noah and his family didn't change. They done what they had to do.
Yeah.
And they still done exactly what God had told them to do.
Yeah.
And that the time came, amen, when the Bible said for Noah and his family to go in the ark. And all the animals that God commanded, amen, to go into the ark.
Yeah.
You know the story. Amen. But after they got in the ark, and the Bible said that God shut the door.
Yeah.
Amen. Then let me tell you what happened. Amen. Them people realize that the alarm that had been sounding day in and day out, and night in and night out, of Noah driving them nails in that ark to build it how God told him to build it. They was reminded of why it was happening. They was reminded of the Lord. When them blue lights come on behind me, I remembered what I should have done.
That's right.
But I'm here to stand before you tonight and tell you it'll be too late.
Yes.
I could not argue.
Oh,
I told that cop that day, I said, oh, I ain't got no excuse. Yes. Amen. I ain't got no excuse.
Yes.
You ain't got no excuse tonight.
Yes.
Amen. You ain't. Yes. You've ignored the alarm.
Yes.
You've ignored the messages
yes.
that your pastor's preached.
Yes.
You've ignored the messages that the men of God is preached.
Yes.
And one day after a while, the alarm's going to cut off.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. Then I had to go up there and talk to that DA. Amen. I went up there and y'all know who she is.
Yeah.
Amen. I gave her that piece of paper and I said, ma'am, I don't know what to do with this. She said, have you ever had one before? I said, no, ma'am, I've not. And I said, I'm real sorry that I got this one. Amen. She looked at me, Brother Todd. And she said, it's took care of. And she went on her way. I want to use Jesus Christ tonight.
Yeah.
And the King Revival.
Yeah.
As the DA.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Amen. The DA's been here this week. All you gotta do is bring your convicted paper before the Lord. And tell him, Lord, I'm sorry. Lord, I'm sorry for my iniquity. Amen. I'm sorry for my shame. I'm sorry for my disobedience. I'm sorry for my willful sin. Amen. And guess what? The DA will look at you and say, it's took care of. But what do you think mercy's for? What do you think the blood of Christ is for? It's to forgive your sin. And if you keep sinning and you keep going the way you're going, that judgment's coming to your house.
That
judgment's coming to your heart. And it'll be too late. The judgment comes.
Amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
I had a choice. Amen. If I wouldn't have went up there, here's what he told me. When he pulled me over, he said, you can either go up there and talk to the DA and get it dropped, or you can show up to court.
Yeah.
You got a choice. Amen.
Yeah.
Y'all see where I'm going?
Yeah.
You can either come tonight and talk to the DA, or you can wait and talk to the judge.
Uh-huh. Amen.
Amen. And I promise you, I promise you the judge is better off. I promise you, you'd be better off to talk to the DA.
Yeah.
Amen. I promise you, you'd be better off to talk to the DA.
Amen.
They've been seeing some of you in your sins in your life that you've been doing for a long time. And you know it's wrong and you've been fighting with it. And you don't want to give up on it. Amen. But I'm telling you, the Bible said, so shall the, as it was in the days of Noah, so shall it be in the coming of the Son of Man.
Amen.
There's not a single soul in this world that knows the coming of the Lord. There's nobody in the world that knows the hour that he's coming back, Brother Paul.
Amen.
But the Father does.
Yes,
and he catches you with sin in your life.
Yeah.
And he catches you unaware. And you know what? I'm afraid that the Lord's going to hear. Amen. Whenever he calls some of us his number, ding, 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 ding,
ding.
He's going to hear the alarm sounding again. And friend, let me tell you, if you die and go to hell, amen, the alarm that you've heard, every message you've heard, every man of God that stood before you, Amen. And you'll hear him preach again.
Amen.
While you're dying and drowning in the flames of hell.
Amen.
You'll hear every altar call that's been given to you over and over and over and over again.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. It's not a question. It's not a question. When I pass a law officer now, one thing I make sure of.
Yeah.
That my seatbelt's on.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Amen.
Yeah.
Amen. I make sure that I've got that fixed because I've never been caught for it.
Yeah.
Amen. The Bible said, him that knoweth to do good and doeth it not, to him it is a sin.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Right. Amen. I want you to know something tonight. Under the sound of my voice, there's no doubt there's people in here where God wouldn't have sent this.
That's right, brother.
Amen. There's no doubt there's people in here that know some things that you're doing that's in your life that you're doing that's wrong.
Yeah.
And you've heard the alarm about it. I'm going to go as far as to say that you've heard the alarm this week in this 10 revival.
Yeah.
Either through Trent opening up service or through the message of somebody. Amen. It's heard the alarm.
Yeah.
And you've not heeded to the call. Amen. But I'm going to tell you about a day that you won't be able to redo. You know them old cassette players. Amen. I used to when I was growing up, amen, daddy had one of them, and if I wanted to hear something again, I would hit rewind.
Yeah.
Amen. But I want to tell you, your life will never rewind.
Amen.
Amen. Your life that you're living,
right,
it's playing one way.
Amen.
And there's not a time that you'll be able to replay.
Oh yeah,
I'd like to replay, amen, some things in my life and mistakes that I made and ponders that I made, but I can't redo them. Amen. I live with scars until the day that I die.
Amen.
But while I'm here, there's a DA that's with me, and he's helping me, and he's convicting me, and he's giving me a chance to make things right.
Yeah.
But you'll get it fixed here or at the judgment.
Amen. Praise the Lord, son.
But if you wait till the judgment, it's too late.
Yeah.
That's right.
It's too late. There ain't gonna be no fixing it up at the judgment.
Yeah.
Amen. A lot of people think they're going to get to the judgment and they're going to say, oh Lord, now I've done this. Lord, I've attended church. Lord, I've sung in the choir. Lord, I've played instruments. Lord, I've been faithful. That ain't going to do you a bit of good.
Right.
Amen. That ain't worth a plug nickel.
That's right.
Amen. I don't care what you do at Cherry Brook. Amen. Don't care what you do at White Oak.
Right.
Amen. What God's going to give account to you is your individual personal life.
Amen.
What you've done with God.
Uh-huh.
Amen. I want to ask you tonight, amen, where would you spend eternity right now if God called your number?
Amen.
Would you die and go to heaven? Could you say, I believe with all my heart, preacher, that I'd make it to heaven?
Amen.
I believe with everything in me.
Come on,
you know what Noah did? Noah sat at his house. He heard the warning of God. He done what God told him to do. Amen. But now it's up to me and you to make sure what we do, the alarms are sounding.
Yeah.
The alarms are sounding. And if some of you could, some of you would unplug it. Amen. Some of you would vote your preacher out if you could.
Amen.
But God's not going to have it that way.
Yeah.
Amen. God said, sound the warning. God said, a watchman on the wall. And he's headed there to help you.
Yeah.
Keep you out of the judgment. I'm standing before God with a ticket in your hand.
Uh-huh. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen. Amen.
God, be mindful.
Brother Trent's the only pastor I know that year.
Touch him, God.
Amen. God said him as a watchman.
Yeah.
God set me up as a watchman.
Yeah.
Amen. We're a watchman to keep over the sheep.
Yeah.
And when the enemy comes, Nehemiah had a burden.
Yes, he did.
I'll be done in a minute.
Nehemiah
had a burden. I had to go back and build back the walls that had been torn down. Amen. Then what was Nehemiah set for? Nehemiah was set for a watchman on the wall. Amen. But when Sanballat, Tobiah, and Geshem come up against him, his job was to sound the warning. Here they come, boys. Get your swords out. Get ready to fight.
Amen.
We got to fight for what's ours. God's give us this freedom, church. God's give you the freedom to worship.
Amen.
And God's give you the freedom to pray for the Lord.
Amen.
And some of you can be in hell tonight.
Amen.
And some of you can be lost and undone without God.
Amen.
Oh, my God. Amen. It's set the correct you. Give you one more chance. Make things right with God. And to hear the warning. And don't unplug the Lord. Just move to Him.
Praise the Lord, brother.
No man, it don't take
praise his holy
long
name.
To get immune
right.
to the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
That's it.
Bless
you. God, happy tonight.
Our first child is 5. Just turned 5.
Touch him.
As the time went on, every little cry that he made, we came to.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah. That's right. That's the truth.
We've heard him.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Uh-huh.
But now we got Jackson. He's 1.
Yeah. Come on.
Now he could cry.
Yeah.
And cry.
Yeah. Whoa.
And cry.
Yeah. Come on, brother. It's the truth.
That's true.
Preach, yeah. Son.
Yeah. And cry.
Help him, God.
Listen, Lord.
You're saying, preacher, you're neglecting.
No.
No.
I've got immune to the crowd.
Amen. That's right, brother.
Listen.
The first, can I tell you something? When you first got saved,
yeah.
You know what you done?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Every time God pricks your heart,
the Lord.
Oh, God, forgive me.
Yeah.
God, forgive me.
That's right. Yeah.
God, forgive me.
Amen.
Come on.
That's good.
Uh-huh. But now, as the years gone by, 5,
yeah.
10, 15 years that went by, you know what will come? Well, he ain't telling me how to live.
That's right.
He ain't
right.
telling me how to
preach.
He ain't telling me how to talk.
Come on,
man. I ain't got to live that way. Oh, you don't have to. No, you don't.
Come on.
Hey, man, but when the DA comes and tells you you can have a plea bargain if you'll just accept the truth.
Yeah.
Hey, man, or you'll stand before the judge.
Amen.
And then you ain't going to have no choice. The Bible said, I told you the other night,
yeah.
Every knee shall bow.
Yeah.
Every tongue shall confess.
Uh-huh.
He is Lord, and what His word says is what you'll be judged by.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Bless him. Immune to the cry. Let me tell you something.
Help him, God.
Bless him, Lord.
There's still a cry.
Uh huh. Lord, be mine.
That both of them boys can make, Brother
Trent.
Yeah.
That tells Daddy.
Uh huh.
They're in trouble.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's right, brother. That's the truth.
Amen.
Uh-huh.
Bless you, Lord.
And I'm hearing the same cry.
Yeah.
Yeah.
In the church.
Oh, Lord, move, I pray, God.
But you ain't crying.
Touch in a mighty way, Lord.
You may not be crying in the natural body, but your spirit is screaming.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Come on, now.
Your spirit. Sister Crystal, if you would come to
God, be mindful, Lord, today.
Oh.
God,
your spirit is screaming.
Yeah.
God be mindful.
So shall it be in the day of the Lord as it was in the day of Noah.
Amen.
I'm not living that way, preacher.
Bless him, Lord.
You better live righteous.
Amen.
You better live holy.
Yeah.
Amen.
You better live clean.
Amen.
You better live pure. Now, if I preach you something and you don't find it in the Word of God, don't live by it.
Amen, brother.
Amen.
But when you can go home and you can open up the pages and Jesus tells you that it's right, you better live by it, friend.
That's right.
Amen.
You better live by it.
That's right.
Amen.
If she plays tonight, everybody stand over the building.
Lord, be mindful, God.
Ding, ding, ding. Ding, 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 ding. It'll quit eventually. It'll quit eventually. It'll go away. It'll go away. Ding, 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 ding. He'll hush in a minute. He'll dismiss church and we'll all go our ways. And nobody will ever know nothing. Ding, 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 ding. Every time you're in church, God's telling you. You need to get rid of that. You need to move up to what the preacher's been preaching. No way. No way. I've just got used to the Lord. I've just got used to the Lord. Sound the warning. But when them little old blue lights come behind me, go, I knowed exactly I'd been caught up to it. And there was not one thing I could do about it. Face it. Face it. Every head bowed and every eye closed. I want to ask you a question tonight. Would there be somebody here that be honest with me and said, "Preacher, the Lord's dealt with my heart over some things in my life. And I've just not been willing. I've just not been willing to do it." Would you just lift your hand up and lift it back down? I'm not going to embarrass you. I'm not going to think any less of you. Bless that hand. Bless you. Bless you. Would there be another? Say, "Preacher, will you please pray for me? There's things God dealt. Bless that hand. There's things God dealt with me over." Would there be another over the building? Bless that hand. Bless that hand. Would there be another? Say, "Preacher, please. Please pray for me. I don't want to get used to the Lord. I don't want to get used to the Lord." Would you lift your hand up and lift it right back down? Bless that hand. Bless that hand. Oh God, church, would you pray? Would there be another? Say, "Preacher, pray for me before I pray." Anybody over the building, say, "Preacher, pray for me." Bless that hand. Anybody else? Before I go to the Lord in prayer, take you before, bless that hand. Would there be another? Would there be another? Oh God, in Jesus' name. God, we come to you tonight thanking the Lord for this opportunity. God, would you please have mercy upon these lives? God, give them more of a chance. Lord, come. Lord, before the day 8 tonight. Lord, in the way things rightly. Lord, please don't let them leave the things in their life and the alarm going off.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, to me, an alarm is annoying. It gets old. Lord, help our people not to get aggravated and annoyed with the alarm, but help them do what they got to do to get the alarm off. Please, Jesus, give them mercy. Give them mercy. Please, Lord. God, I love you and I thank you tonight. Oh, God, draw us back. This altar's still open. This altar's still open. You know who you are that raised your hand. I beg you, as she plays and sings, whatever she's going to do, I beg you to please make your way to this altar. Because there'll be a day where the district attorney won't be able to help you. When God judges me and you, there's nothing. There's nothing, Brother Paul. Jesus can say, "But Father," he's going to say, "Son, right here's your life." Jesus Christ being the deity. Will you please come tonight? Will you please come? Get rid of that pride that's in your heart. Step out of your aisle. Make your way to this altar. Say, "God, please. Please. Help me move. Help me move. Bless your joy. Bless your joy." Some of y'all need more praise. Lord, touch them tonight, Jesus. Lord, touch them tonight, Jesus. Would there be more? There's more that raised your hand. Would you please? Would you please? You ain't got to leave here with the Lord. You ain't got to leave here listening to that Lord. God, we should take it. You know, we've sat in a church house and we've tried every way in the world. every way in the world to unplug the Lord.
Come on, brother.
We've tried, Brother Raymond, to get rid of it. Because it's every time we go to church, we hear it. Uh-huh. Ain't that an evident fact?
Yes.
Ain't that an evident fact? That we ought to put our seatbelt on? If every time I crank my truck up and put it in drive, that alarm goes off. It's evident fact that I ought to know by now what to do.
Praise His holy name.
One more second, and I'm going to give it back to Brother Trent.
Yes, Lord.
Anybody. Anybody.
Thought about when they was going in by twos. And here they was, and these people are looking at them. And there's this nut that built this boat. Well, he's getting animals of two in there. What's going on with that? Then all of them got in. You reckon what they thought when they seen that great big door shut and there wasn't nobody a hold of it?
Amen.
Yeah.
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 Amen.
Bible said that he pitched it within and without.
Yeah.
There wasn't no sound that he could hear inside that ark, I believe. Then all of a sudden, they're going to drop a rain, starts falling. Dad, what do you say? Mom, what's going on?
Yeah.
Then here it comes. Water starts rising. What is all this? Mm-hmm. Then they realize the old preacher man was right.
Amen.
We should have heeded the warning.
Yeah.
We had opportunity.
Yeah.
We had a chance. But they all died.
Yeah. Amen.
I appreciate God, don't you?
Yeah.
I appreciate Him sending warnings. I appreciate what He's done for us.
Amen.
Thinking this evening, brother, I tell you what. What a message. What a messenger.
Yeah. Amen. We need to pray for these men. Yes. Pray for Amen. Our preachers. Yeah. Pray that God just keep preaching the power and the demonstration. Yeah. I sit back and watch them preach, and it amazed me. Amen. To see how God uses them.
Yeah,
thank the Lord for that. Amen. Amen. Thought about this and not me done. Thinking this evening there, his preaching, and then when we come this way and home today, I thought about Abraham. I thought about Sarah. At old age, she had a son. I thought about, was actually the only son that Abraham had for us with his wife. But he had Ishmael. But I thought about when the Lord spoke to him and said, it's time to take you for the offering. I'm just briefing it there. Abraham got everything prepared and got ready. He set him up on the ice, the Bible said. Had the wood. Had everything, the offering. Isaac said, where is the sacrifice?
Yeah.
Did God want Isaac?
No.
He wanted Abraham.
Yes, he did.
Man.
He wanted Abraham.
Amen.
He didn't want it to be Abraham and Isaac. He wanted it to be God and Abraham.
Amen.
God wants you tonight to be God in you.
Yes.
God in you.
Amen.
God didn't need Isaac.
No.
And you think about this. Whatever's in your life tonight that's hindered you, that's hurt you, God can get rid of that.
Oh, yeah. Yes.
That broke Abraham's heart. You know it did.
Sure.
But he went.
Yeah.
And he got it all the way down to, and he prepared, just like Noah, done the ark. Got everything ready. And went to kill him.
Yeah, he did. Yeah.
And hit a break in his heart.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
You may be here tonight, and it may be the closest thing to your heart that you're going to have to get rid of.
That's right.
Amen. It may be the closest thing to your heart that we have to get rid of.
Oh, yeah.
It may be something nobody don't know about.
That's right.
It may be something that's in your life. It'll drive you nuts to get rid of it.
Yeah.
But guess what? When he prepared it, laid the wood to him, tied him up, laid him up on him,
yeah,
and threw back. Something over here in the bush, he started rattling the bush.
Yeah.
Yeah. God made a way.
Amen.
Sometimes the Lord wants to see how far we'll go.
That's right.
That's right, Trent.
See how far we're willing to step
out. Amen.
Even though it'll break our heart.
Oh, yeah.
We'll be willing to go.
Amen. Amen. Yeah. That's
God
good, Trent.
No.
Amen.
He wanted a faithful father.
Amen.
That would listen to what he wanted to do.
Yeah.
You young preachers. God wants a faithful preacher.
Yeah.
Yes, he does.
That would listen to what. There may be something bobbing your life that you love dearly. You may have to. Layer on the altar.
That's right.
Get rid of it. God will meet you.
Amen. Amen.
God wants you to preach, son.
Yeah.
God wants us. I thought about this. I used to be bad to say God didn't need me. God can do anything. God does need you too.
Right. Yeah.
He God made does you. Need you too. Well, preacher, what does God need me for? How else is the word going to be put out to me?
That's right.
To let their light shine.
Yeah.
You can see the goodness of God.
Right.
Amen.
You can send out the warnings, as Brother Nathan, Brother Dale's preached this well. Not had nothing to what I tell you what, I believe that's the best I've ever heard the man preach.
Yeah.
God has anointed him.
Yeah.
And I thank God for that. I thank God that my youngins. Because to say, I thought about these kids that are coming in this altar. I thought about Deanna. I thought about all the ones that size
Praise the Lord. Get to sit under the Holy Ghost preaching.
Yeah.
Hear the man of God stand up and preach the infallible word. Not back down, not give up. That's what our people need.
Amen.
That's what our children need.
Yes.
My kids need it. My boy needs it. Your youngins need it.
Yes.
Now praise the Lord tonight. Amen. Thank God for all that He's done. Thank Him for this tent meeting.
Yes.
Praise the Lord tonight for the men that held it.
Yeah, thank
God's been good, ain't he?
Yeah.
Praise His holy name tonight. I thank Him. I thought about Brother Nathan, said he's free. Amen. Said he's free. Hate to see it end, but there's no point if the burden's gone, there's no point in dragging her on out.
That's right.
But we don't have to let it stop here.
Amen.
So let's take what God has sent. Somebody said, well, was there any soul saved? Was there anything happened? I really don't know. I've seen people get in the altar every night. I don't know if anybody got saved or not, or am I rededicated their life? I don't know. But what I do know is that God sent message after message to the church.
Yes.
Right. To the church.
Yes.
Not Cherethbrook.
Right.
Not White Oak.
Right.
To the church.
Amen.
The church.
Amen.
Amen. The church is leaving here.
Amen.
He sent this morning, this week.
Yeah.
Amen.
And we've got to heed it. We've got to hear it.
Yeah.
So let's apply it to our life.
Yes.
Let's take it back to the building that we worship in.
Yeah.
And let's do our best.
Yeah.
For God.
Yeah. Amen.
I love you tonight. I appreciate everybody.
Yes.
I thank God tonight for this. Amen. Amen. Is all hearts and minds clear?
Got one thing.
Go ahead, brother.
Bless him before we leave. We've got five young preachers in my church.
Yeah.
And all five of them are going to be preaching this week.
Amen.
One of them is going to be preaching Wednesday night to church. The others is going to be preaching up there at the youth thing this weekend.
Praise the Lord.
And I'd like for us to come around.
Yes.
And that pray that God will give them anointing
that
they've never had before.
Amen.
That's all right. Yeah. I don't want to get out of the way, but I really feel like that we need to do that.
Yeah.
Because right, this week's been easy on them.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Because they've been in church every night.
Yeah.
But now, tomorrow night,
they're
going to face
it.
I know Jaron and David's been preaching a little longer than the other three. They've kind of got their feet in the saddle, as old saying goes. These other three are going to have to face some real hard trouble.
Oh, yeah.
They are.
Yeah.
So I feel like we need to pray as a church.
We need
to pray as a church that the Lord will really help him.
Yeah.
Because like you said, your young ones, you're going to be dead and gone one day.
That's right.
Yeah.
And these younger men that's coming up may be what's preaching to yours.
That's right.
And if they ain't got the anointing of God, they won't do your young ones no good.
Amen.
They won't do my young ones no good.
That's right.
But if they've got the anointing, they can help.
Oh, yeah.
Amen. So I feel like we're doing that before we leave.
That'll be great, brother.
Oh, yeah.
I feel like we need to do that. So.
Yeah. Let's come. Come on, boys. Look at this.
Amen.
Look at that.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
That's enough to shout.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
I hope God gives them backbone like crowbar.
Oh, yeah. All the men gather around, probably you women can just gather in behind the men. We'll just all gather around, stand in a circle, whatever you need to do. Let's really pray for them. Oh, God, in Jesus' name. Lord, help them tonight.
Bless the Lord tonight, God. We thank you again for the privilege and honor to pray with these men.
Thank you, Lord.
God, I thank you, Lord, today, God, for this, Lord, another time. I pray, God, you take these men, God, and give them life today. I pray you give them life on like a soul, Lord, God. They stay in love for what's right and against what's wrong. God, I pray you move their lives and give them wisdom, knowledge, and understanding, God. We pray. We ask you tonight, Father, that you would, Lord, to lead, guide, and direct in all ways. I pray. Father, I love you tonight, God. I praise you tonight, God, for this man. God, the courage, Lord, you give them. Help them, oh God, to stay in the evil days. Help them, oh God, to stay.
Said. Amen. Amen.